You know what game we haven't played in well over a month? Well, it's Driving Empire. This is normally the game that I go to the most, but I think they've been preparing one of their biggest updates ever. If you guys don't follow their social media or their Discord, they've been posting a lot of stuff about new updates that are coming out very, very soon. I'm looking forward to seeing some of the stuff that they have coming out. And yeah, if you guys don't follow it, you should, because there's a lot. But we haven't played the game in over a month, and it just felt weird to not try it out today. There's not really much going on today, other than an update later for Drive City, my game, but that's not going to be till later today. So before we do that, I think we should do a video on Driving Empire. Now, if you guys haven't noticed, things have changed around. Little things, like the UI has changed a little bit. This UI layout is much, much better. This basically sorts every single issue I had with the old UI. You can search for whatever car you want, you can filter by different things like the price of the vehicle, the year of the vehicle, new vehicles, track vehicles, and even specifically off-sale vehicles. So if we go here, we can actually see that there is actually a bunch of cars that are no longer available for purchase at all. No matter what you do, you cannot own these cars if you don't already. Luckily, I do seem to own quite a few, but some of these don't even have a price on them. Everything here is no longer for sale, which is kind of weird. This is actually really sick. Look at this Lamborghini Huracan. Maybe someday they'll bring some of those cars back, but today I wanted to buy something, just something different, you know, just to try something out, get back into the game, do some of the races that we don't typically do, like the circuit race and some of the other ones as well. But I'm just trying to figure out what car do I want. Maybe we should go with the Koenigsegg Jira RS. I don't buy this car in a lot of games, and this is obviously a very, very nice car. So let's buy it in white. I don't know why, but they just look the nicest in white to me. I guess it's the blue and the white and everything, but yeah, the stats are pretty insane. 285 mile per hour top speed and 2.9 seconds 0 to 60 for a pretty reasonable $2.8 million. I mean, that's some insane stats for the price, so I'm honestly pretty happy with that purchase. Now, the only thing they haven't done much with is this UI, this vehicle UI menu. They should definitely have the same sort of sorting system so that you can find the car you're actually looking for, because scrolling through this menu, especially if you're on mobile, is probably not that great. You know, we haven't played this game in so long that I almost forgot how good of a game it actually is. Like, it's really been a long time, but yeah, the models in this game are by far probably the nicest models out of any racing game on Roblox. The only game I can think of with similar quality of models is Horizon, but that game's nowhere near as advanced as Driving Empire is. But either way, let's check this out, guys. We've got fully carbon fiber rims, so there's no need to adjust that. I guess we just go straight into the performance stuff. Let's get the drag engine here. Does give us some insane stat increases, so we will take that. 300k though. Superchargers, another 42k as well. Of course, we will equip the premium boost, and I guess we get out of here. I can't really think of anything else that I would want at this moment, so let's just go ahead and pull out. Yeah, this thing is just ridiculously fast already. Well, without further ado, let's see what we can do here. Okay, yeah, this thing is insane. Just as I would have expected. Let's go do the city quarter mile first, and then from there we will try to set up some more races. Okay, we're versing a Bugatti Veyron. This should be pretty exciting, actually. Koenigsegg versus Bugatti Veyron. It looks like someone else is trying to join as well. Oh, there's Mr. ABD. He's pulling in here. His Koenigsegg actually looks very, very nice. I won't even lie. I really like the way he did his up. But yeah, here we go. This is the first race we've done in over a month, guys. It would be pretty cool to win the first ever race that we've done. So, it does look like my car didn't spawn properly, but here we go anyways. Let's go. All right, there's the boost. Oh my god, the Bugatti Veyron is so fast. Okay, I think we beat ABD. Yeah, we beat ABD quite a lot, actually. But dude, that Veyron was much faster than I thought it was going to be. Holy crud. Okay, let's do the city race now. This is another race I've really wanted to try out. Okay, you know what? We're gonna do the circuit race. This is a race I really don't do often, and there's honestly no good excuse. I just don't do this race too much. It's kind of out of the way, and a lot of people don't do it. So because it's not popular, there's not usually a lot of people wanting to race. Okay, it looks like a couple of people are joining. There is quite a number of fast cars. I wonder if that Bugatti is gonna come back for another race. Let's see. Oh, he is. Is he? He's only got 1 second. Oh, he's not gonna make it. He's not gonna make it. How unfortunate. Anyways, we'll also try out the highway race after this as well. But yeah, I love this little cutscene before a race starts. That is so sick. All right, with that being said, guys, let's get started here. 3, 2, 1, and here we go. We're off. First circuit race in probably like 6 months, maybe more. Honestly, it's been way too long. Oh gosh, wait, what the heck? I thought I was in first until I saw the way they jumped over a bunch of the checkpoints. I won't lie, when you're in really quick cars like this one, this race feels really, really, really small. It feels like you're constantly braking, but I guess it's because of how quick this thing is. Come on. Come on, here we go. It feels like I'm actually doing quite well at the moment. Nobody else is even near me. I've been holding first position this entire first lap, so let's see if we can continue this into the second lap. This would be pretty good. I actually, there's the other guy. He's way back there. Oh God, oh no, I had to mess up, no. Okay, that was a pretty brutal mess up there. But it does look like I might still be okay. Is nobody else really in first? Really? That was a pretty big mistake. Maybe the UI is just not working correctly, but I definitely don't think I should be in first right now. There's somebody right here as well. I don't know if he's in first or if he's missing checkpoints or what. It definitely looks like he's missing checkpoints though. Okay, I am maximum focus mode, trying to win this thing. Oh gosh, come on. Okay, that's a good area to cut through. There it is. Oh, come on, get ahead, yes. Oh, no way, it comes down to this final stretch. Who's gonna get first? Let's see. Oh, we did it. 1:14, and now we're flying into space. Not too bad. Not too bad. Alrighty, guys, we're getting into the around the city now. I've been waiting to do this race, and I thought I'd leave it for the last one because, well, it's just a cool race. I really like these cutscenes. This is something Drive City needs, definitely. These cutscenes are super cool. Of course, our competition is two other Bugatti Veyrons, the only cars that have defeated us today. Oh God, okay, let's see how we can do in the around the city. This isn't a quarter mile, so we should be able to do a little bit better. Did a little better on the braking there, so oh God, the curbs. The one thing about Driving Empire is I feel like the turning is very, very touchy. Maybe it's just the way the game is designed, but oh no, you're joking. You're joking right now. No, dude, this is something that shouldn't happen, I think. That's a rip. All right, attempt number two, I guess. Okay, here we go, attempt number two. Let's not get stuck on a wall this time, guys. I'm feeling better about this one. I do feel like that little wall there might be a problem for a lot of people because we really didn't mess up that badly. I mean, we just kind of crashed into it, but yeah, we got stuck halfway in between. We'll learn from it, and from now on, we won't make the same mistake again, but we're kind of versing the same people again, except this time with a Koenigsegg as well. So two Bugattis versus two Ajiras. Let's see how we do here. Okay, this is where I messed up last time. Not this time, wall. Not this time. Oh, ABD got stuck. I feel that. That is exactly what happened to me too. It's these pesky little white and red walls. You gotta be very careful around them, but that first lap felt really, really quick. Okay, come on, here we go. So I feel like as long as we do the second lap the same way we did the first, we should be able to get the victory royale. This is it, guys, this is it. No big mistakes, and we can walk away with the victory royale. Let's go, dude. First place. Did anybody else come to finish it as well? Let's see. Oh, here they come now. Wow, there's one. Oh God, he crashed right into the wall. Oh my gosh. Okay, and I think the other guy is just about to make it as well. Oh, okay. Anyways, guys, I'm gonna wrap things up here. I really can't wait for the next Driving Empire update. If you guys want to see more content on this game, just leave this video a big thumbs up. Let me know what you guys want to see next time. Also, my game Drive City does get an update today, which hopefully you guys will enjoy. So check the game out. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you all in the next Driving Empire video.